Internal energy. The sum of all the microscopic forms of energy is called the internal energy of a system. The internal energy of a system is denoted by the symbol U or E, and SI unit is joule. The term internal energy and its symbol U first appeared in the works of Rudolph Clausius and William Rankine in the second half of the 19th century. The internal energy of a system has two components, and they are kinetic energy and potential energy. Kinetic energy. The kinetic energy component consists of various types of molecular motion and the movement of electrons within molecules. Now, potential energy. Potential energy is determined by the attractive interaction between electrons and nuclei and by repulsive interaction between electrons and between nuclei in individual molecules, as well as by the interaction between molecules. Some microscopic internal energy forms. Here are some microscopic internal energy forms: sensible energy, latent energy, chemical energy, and nuclear energy. Let's shortly discuss these internal energy forms. First, sensible energy. The portion of the internal energy of a system associated with the kinetic energies of the molecules is called the sensible energy, such as translational kinetic energy, rotational kinetic energy, vibrational kinetic energy, electrostatic, and spin energy. Then, latent energy. The internal energy associated with the phase of a system is called the latent energy. Next is chemical energy. The internal energy associated with the atomic bonds in a molecule is called chemical energy. Now the last one, nuclear energy. The tremendous amount of energy associated with the strong bonds within the nucleus of the atom itself is called nuclear energy. Internal energy is an extensive property. That means its magnitude depends on the amount of substance in a given state. Actually, we cannot calculate the absolute value for the internal energy of a system because it is extremely difficult to account for all the individual energies that give rise to the kinetic and potential energies. So, the change in the internal energy is measurable. The internal energy is also a state function in the sense that its value depends only on the current state of the system and is independent of how that state has been prepared. So, the change in internal energy is equal to final value of internal energy minus initial value of internal energy. When a system changes from an initial state with internal energy to a final state of internal energy, thus, del U can be written as del U of a system is equal to UF minus UI or Q plus W, where Q is denoting energy in the form of heat exchanged between system and surroundings, and W is denoting work done by or on the system. Internal energy of an ideal gas. In kinetic theory of ideal gases, we assume that there is no force of attraction or repulsion between the molecules of the gas except the collision between them. Therefore, there is no potential energy in ideal gases. This means that the internal energy consists only of kinetic energy. So, the internal energy of the ideal gas depends on the number of degrees of freedom of the molecules. What is degree of freedom? The term degree of freedom of the system tells us about the number of free or independent motion of the system. It is denoted by F. Thus, F is equal to 3 multiplied by number of atoms in the molecules minus number of relations between the molecules. The internal energy for 1 mole of a gas, U, is equal to F divided by 2 multiplied by N into RT. So, the internal energy of a gas increases with the increase in temperature. Monatomic gas molecule. A monatomic molecule is one in which atoms are not bound to each other. it has at least 3 degrees of freedom at normal temperature. Therefore, the internal energy of a monatomic gas is U is equal to 3 by 2 into N R T. For example, helium, neon, argon, etc. Vibrational energy. A monatomic gas has no vibrational energy because a vibrational mode requires at least 2 atoms for changing the distance or angle between atoms in a single molecule. A monatomic gas has no other atoms in respect to which it can vibrate. Rotational energy. This molecule has no rotational energy. Although a monatomic molecule can also rotate, but due to its small moment of inertia, rotational energy can be neglected. Translational energy. For a monatomic ideal gas, the only contribution to the energy comes from translational kinetic energy. Thus, translational degree of freedom is equal to 3. So, total degree of freedom F is equal to 3. Thus, U is equal to 3 by 2 N R T. Now, diatomic molecule. Diatomic ideal gases are made up of 2 atoms joined rigidly to one another through a bond. They generally show only 5 degrees of freedom at normal temperature. Thus, U is equal to 5 by 2 N R T, such as hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, etc. Next is translational energy. The diatomic molecule has 3 degrees of freedom for translational motion. Here comes rotational energy. This molecule can rotate about 3 mutually perpendicular axes. But the moment of inertia about the z-axis of rotation is negligible compared to other 2 axes such as x and y. Hence, it has only 2 rotational degrees of freedom. Next one is vibrational energy. It has also one molecular vibration mode where the 2 atoms oscillate back and forth with the chemical bond between them acting as a spring. But at normal temperatures, it is unable to exhibit vibration. At high temperature, it has also energy to undergo vibrational motion. Thus, at normal temperature, a diatomic molecule has 5 degrees of freedom, 3 translational and 2 rotational. So, U is equal to 5 by 2 N R T. There are 2 ways to change the internal energy of a system. Heat is the transfer of thermal energy into the system from the surroundings and work done by the system on the environment. Characteristics of internal energy. Firstly, internal energy of a system is an extensive property. So, its property depends on the amount of substance in a given state. Secondly, internal energy is a state property. That means its value depends on the current state of the system and is independent of how the state has been prepared. Thirdly, internal energy of an ideal gas depends only on its temperature. Thus, if the temperature of a system increases, the kinetic and potential energies of the atom and molecules in the system increase. Next, internal energy change in a cyclic process is zero. Such as in a cyclic process, initial and final states are same. That's all for this session. If you like this video, please like, share and comment if you have any suggestions. Please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, Kinetic School. Thank you for being with us.